ABC, 1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, girl. All right. Jackson 5, everybody. Actually, when Michael Jackson was tolerable. What's going on, everybody? Good evening. And this is going to be my first report, if you will, with my new Samson Meteor mic, USB studio microphone for computer recording. Picked it up right here off of Amazon, Amazon.com. And this is kind of the first real true test of the mic. And I have to say, so far, I did a couple other tests just on my own, and it was quite enjoyable, actually. I think the quality, which hopefully you can tell right off the bat, sounds better than before what I was using it, which I was just using just a regular, actually it was a USB headset designed for the PlayStation 3, which worked fine, but this will allow me maybe to get like actual conversations. The other one was, you know, just over my head, microphone in front of my mouth. But this being a microphone, like an actual kind of like an old school studio microphone, it looks like, hopefully will allow for more, livelier conversations, because it will just allow, introduce, I'll be able to bring other people in, and hopefully everyone will be able to homogenize properly. So I figure let's kind of kick this whole thing off. There's a craze that's happening on the internet that really busts my buttons. Look, I'm all about making awareness for stuff. I'm all about with donations. I'm all about causes if they're the right causes. There's a lot of causes out there that don't make sense or for the wrong thing. But this ice bucket challenge that is raising awareness for ALS. Look, if you want to raise awareness for ALS, then just tell people to donate money for ALS. Basically, what you're doing is your challenge. Here's what happens. You go on your challenge. I don't know who started it, but someone started it. You challenge somebody to just simply pour a bucket of cold ice water over them. And then you challenge people. They have 24 hours to do it. So, A, it's very inconvenient. Because, you know, a lot of things happen. You can't just put to the side, you know, 24 hours, let's do dump water on my head. So highly inconvenient. Two, you know, if they don't do the challenge within 24 hours, then they're forced, quote unquote, to donate $100 to ALS research, which the donation is fine. Don't get me wrong. Donation's good, but you're forced into it. You're almost shamed into it, because if you don't do the challenge, and $100, I mean, come on, that's ridiculous. $10, okay, $25, fine, if you're feeling gracious, $50. $100, to bet someone $100, look, I'm a degenerate gambler, or, you know, I've lost tons of money in Atlantic City and Vegas, and really not even going playing machines, but be that as it may, $100, if you forget or don't dump water on your head, it's stupid. So everyone's doing this ice bucket challenge. All right, fine. For those who dump the water on their head, I want to know, are you making the donations? Because if you get 100 people challenged for the ice bucket and only 10 of them don't do it, all right, fine. It's 1,000. 10, 100. That's $1,000, which is fine, but, you know, 100 people times $100 is $10,000. So if you really want to do justice and actually bring awareness, don't dump the water on your head. Donate the money, but not $100. Come on, don't be nuts. Donate whatever you can. It's just, it's ridiculous. It's a fad. It's dumb. It's stupid. Don't dump water on your head. All right, be that as it may, hopefully, if you're still listening right now and you're not mad at me, Look, that's just my opinion. Everyone's entitled to their opinion, even though there may be some people out there who feel otherwise. But, you know, listen, everyone has a right to say what they want to say and feel how they want to feel. Hopefully this, with the microphone, with the new microphone, is actually giving a little bit of a different turn here with the podcast, with the series. Hopefully I'll be doing this more often, hoping to invite more people into it, which pretty much all my podcasts sound the same thing. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Now I'm getting serious. I have one more piece of equipment that's coming in before I really start to branch out. And really, I mean, I see myself very shortly, you know, maybe putting investing some more money into this. So we're going to see what happens. But coming up this weekend, SummerSlam, maybe tomorrow, I will give some more information, you know, my predictions about SummerSlam. Friday, I'll be in MCU Park in Brooklyn for Field of Honor. Ring of Honor, for the first time ever, will be at MCU Park for a tremendous night of wrestling. Steel cage match that night. That should be pretty cool. Outside under the stars. Jerry Lynn's going to be there for a special autograph signing. Finally, I'll get my Maria Kanellis autograph. Of course, not on the Playboy magazine, because I believe, quote-unquote, Superstorm Sandy took care of that. But I got something around here she can sign. A card. Thank you. Next week, I'll give some, you know, my feedback on Ring of Honor. I'm kind of excited. I've never been to a Ring of Honor show. So, you know, WWE definitely. I went to TNA last week for... Wow. Hold on. This apparently picks up everything. Okay, well, next week I'll give my reaction with Ring of Honor, let you know what I thought of it, how the matches went. And we'll see, maybe we'll do a post-SummerSlam show as well. So I'm looking towards new great things here with this. Look out for more shows, some more guests, and quite frankly, just keep on keeping on. All right, folks, I'll catch you next time.